I am here. Had to set up my stream manager on my laptop so I can monitor everything. Did some testing with different setups, so there may be some weirdness. Okay, it's showing you. Yay! Cool. Fan-friggin-tastic. Alright. Let's see if the connection holds up. I am sort of saying that ironically. Croissant. I don't know. Croissant. Sounds silly. Eh, whatever. Don't mind me, I'm just a bear doing bear things. Trying not to get crushed by a son of Argal. This is my second horde druid. of hardcore. All right, things are pretty quiet. Let's start some music. Territory. But one shouldn't break it. Now to find my exit. Just my own volume. So I suggest you all do the same, because it's been a challenge. This isn't like an introductory seed because I've done it before. I did some weird settings here and there. Not too weird though. I wanted to ease into streaming with it at a reasonable level with, I don't know, some low level frigging options settings. Not necessarily like hardest of the hard, because we don't need that. And this is done casually, not fucking done professionally. Yourselves in so far as you can. Or need to. Doing a far away from, or further away from mouth thing with my mic. We'll see how it works out. I've been watching back a couple of my streams today, and those pregnant sighs are getting annoying. Same with heavy breathing after coming back from breaks. I don't breathe that heavy, do I? Well, yeah, otherwise, just, like, in general, check my breathing.
You have served me well, Major. It is obvious to me that you will be a worthy aid to me as I prepare to rid Silver Pine Forest of Arugul's curse. How Arugul gained acceptance within the Kirin Tor is beyond me. His spellcasting knowledge seemed as transparent as a blown glass bauble. What's important now is learning exactly what magic Arugul used so that I can turn it against him and secure Silver Pine Forest for the Dark Lady. Arugul first stayed at the wheat farm just north of the bridge. One of the Deathstalkers reported seeing some spell books but could not secure them. Retrieve for me the spell labeled Remedy of Arugul from those books.
He's over on the left. Don't worry about it.
Thank you.
A bit tricky for me to nose breathe as opposed to mouth breathe. Just because I got so much gunk in my nose all the time, I'm not sure why. Plus my nose is a little fucked up.
Yes, I can feel it working. I will soon be able to travel. You have done me a great favor, adventurer.
Tarn too tall.
My brother Quinn and I were tasked to recon Silverpine Forest and report to High Executor Hadrick, but we didn't get far. When moving through this farm, we were attacked by the ghoul Ivar the Foul. We escaped from Ivar, but he seriously mauled Quinn. He's healing from the potion you gave him, but Ivar may return before Quinn recovers. Kill Ivar so Quinn will have time to heal. Ivar is usually in the barn yonder, waiting for my guard to drop.
That one of them likes pop in and out of the barn. It's best to wait for that. So you're not utterly besieged. Also, one of the patrols inside. Another one of them. I've done this quest a lot. Let's just say that. Alright. guy is a pain in the ass. He knows you cannot pull rat fuck of a retainer off to fight. Not like I ever got.
What? Thank you. You have my gratitude, adventurer, and I will include you in the report I make to my superiors.
I did have some close calls. Of course, I've also breezed through that quest because there were other people in the area doing it too. Other bears. As you do. Is red. That's cool. I think I stopped progress. Record time. Well, shit. All right, let's fight other bears now. These random patrols. Not even patrols. It's like they're running straight at you. The fuck, bear. You need to die. You're too crazy out here. Thank you. Hey, turn around. Dark. When's a Smargle gonna patrol through? Nobody knows. Battles wisely, because you never know when something else might come to party. And together, they will kill your ass. Hunter's mark on him. What? Bad man. Just so he knows where he is. I think. Let's retreat behind this tree. So I'm not spotted at all. That badass motherfucker. Strolling around at 36%. Fuck you right up. Too, if you manage to get away, it'll still kill you.
What is it? Trust no one.
Suck my ass there. My prey. bits off the crowd so people coming out can actually get out and not risk death. Full heal, please. Good old waltz, menacingly. In there. Definitely going to be staying in form a lot more. So I want to maintain my energy. But for now, it's whatever. All the time. Because you're a fucking bear. You don't have any distance bolts, holy shit. You gotta break the form in order to do the distance bolts. You gotta break form in order to heal yourself. You gotta break form to do anything that isn't bear-like. Aside from skinning the enemy and taking herbs. Bears can do that, right? Right. not sound familiar. Oh yeah, it's from a game I've never played. Okay. I've heard about it. I've seen it played. Never played it. Because I was either playing World of Warcraft or Minecraft. Good for me. Why Minecraft when I'm 25 years old? I don't know. Fucking Minecraft. Why Minecraft when I'm almost 34? I don't know. Fucking Minecraft. Stretchly, we need to talk, and you're not into listening. Okay, there you go. Stream time means you cannot frickin' ding me, okay? Good job. That's what the in-game dinging is for. Warcraft, because I could die. Fucking thing blocks like 70% of my screen. The semi-transparent thing that I can't dismiss. Because I told it I can't dismiss it. Because I have a problem with getting up when I should. Although World of Warcraft is easy to get up and leave because it's a freaking old ass game with dated mechanics and gameplay that makes me want to cry. No wonder I have no viewers. Oh well. I'm gonna integrate more retro type games into my lineup because that is kind of the niche I want to fill. And everybody and the grandmother is doing World of Warcraft right now on streams. It's hard to break in here. And we're not doing it. I don't want to rant about depressing shit, so I'm just gonna drop it there. Okay, I forget. Did I hate being caught with my pants down. Might as well start attack when I'm trying to demoralizing roller. Pressing 4. And hopefully I will not die the way I died last time on a druid. By ignoring the fact that I was not auto-attacking. I was too stressed out. Mobs all over. That was off screen. That was way before I started streaming, so. Some people are concerned I only started streaming last Monday. But no, like five days past that. So they're not all wrong. they're not entirely wrong. I am still really new. Not because they're particularly tough, it's just because they don't drop the frickin' cuffs I need when I do go after them. RNG. Bullshit. With a son of Aragal in the mix. Nameplate in classic era, you've already pulled him. There's another. Where the fuck is he? Just so you know, there isn't just one of these. There's at least 4 in the zone. Just a bear doing bear things. Ignore me.
This is precisely the spell I was in search of, adventurer. If your dedication to the Dark Lady's cause remains infallible, you will find you have quite a future amongst the Forsaken. After examining Arugal's work, my worst suspicions were confirmed. The old hack was not qualified to clean chamber pots in Dalaran, let alone represent the Kirin Tor in its most dire hour. Fools! Arugal used enchanted items to reinforce his weak magic. I need to examine these items firsthand. Travel forth and slay Moonrage Gluttons and Moonrage Dark Souls until you have collected enough of their enchanted shackles for my research. The foul creatures have been seen to the north and east. I heard of your successful raid against the Rothides, adventurer, and this essence is proof of Nightlash's death. The Scourge have lost ground this day. Your value to the Forsaken grows. Adventurer, we've discovered a new hive for the Scourge. The Decrepit Ferry. The ferry lies east of the Sepulchre and is heavily patrolled by Rothides and other undead. There must be a reason for the Scourge's occupation of the area. Go to the Decrepit Ferry and find out why the Scourge are there.
Speak quickly.
That's the stuff.
Watch your back.
Did you not see it? The shackles. On the one hand, I'm pretty good at avoiding Son of Argal. On the other, there is a lot of werewolves in the area. So, I don't know if now is the time to potion for the hour. Because there is another really hard part after. Mages. I hate mages. I also have the raptors that killed my last druid. But that's not until around 18 or 20. Let's not wander into a whole camp, okay? Ah! The sun! Okay. Yeah, we're gonna wait for that to pass by. Or, wander around. Whatever floats your boat, big guy. Nearly pulled that motherfucker. Thinking he was a normal frickin' werewolf. Goddamn unit scan's not warning me about him yet. He did before. But not consistently. Not constantly. Constant reminders for that kind of shit. Well, at least we're getting a lot of gluttons. I usually end up getting stuck to the south or west, rather. Get into the territory with the dark souls. And end up over-farming the Dark Souls. One of these days, motherfucker. Back here, I'm gonna whoop your ass. This one in particular. Enough for social aggro. Music's making me think of that. That'll be later. Once I start to transition off of World of Warcraft, for instance, and onto Earthbound or something. I need something addictive to pull my focus away from World of Warcraft so I can set this addictive ass game aside, finally. I was almost there too. I mean, Minecraft addiction for me is Jesus. I almost said, fuck it, let's do Minecraft instead every single day since I did the test stream. Well, it's only been a couple days, but still. Next day, I was like, okay, fuck everything. Let's play Minecraft. On stream, because I want to build a career for myself somehow, and I want to do it some way that feels comfortable. And not totally frustrating. Like school is at the moment. Having to learn new terminology day by day. You good, bro? You do you. I'll be over here healing my own ass. Making sure I don't die. Here. Have that. Oh my god. Seriously. Why are you trying to die? What is it with some warlocks and going ham when you don't need to go ham? I just sit back and chill as a warlock. Let the dots do the work. Let the Voidwalker get threat. This guy fucking going balls to the wall. Nearly dying. You crazy, bro. Don't take too many risks. There. Too many risk, you die. Okay, break. I need to find a spot to log out. Think about what to do for dinner. Thinking salmon. Start the oven preheating and then I'll come back, do more stream, then put the salmon in. Alright, BRB. After this 20-second logout sequence. Seconds. One viewer, probably me. Okay, I'm gonna throw it into BRB mode. It dawns on me that maybe, just maybe, I should. Off in-game music so you guys can enjoy out-of-game music. Okay, be right back. Stream resumes now. That fucker. Yes.
Okay.
Oh. Thank you for your tribute of stuffs. Stuffs to vendor. Party next door. See how this goes. Normally go around the other side. So this is not the best. Thank you. extra watchful. Fuck up. Alright. And we'll see how easy the mages are gonna be today. Might not have to use my buffs. Because I really should be saving them for the raptors. Fucking raptors, man. Raptor grounds are a shit show. Like it's partially clear. Oh yeah. Hello, Mr. Sir. Well, cool. That was easy. Didn't have to do anything. That's what happens sometimes in that area. Which is why I wait before I do my buffs. I'm gonna snag this Void Walker with buffs. Just you watch. Although, actually, he does get dismissed, so it's like, I don't care. Snag this guy instead. How about that? Hunter pets. When dismissed, do not lose their buffs. Warlock pets, when dismissed, do lose their buffs. It is unfortunate. good. Got through frickin' Silverpine.
Speak maps and this...
Nice and easy.
Pendant, HM? Interesting. It is obvious that the Dalaran wizards are interested in Ambermill for some purpose. But still, their aim is hidden to me. Perhaps Dalar will know something of their use.
Take the pendant to Dalar Dawnweaver. Perhaps he can shed some light on the wizard's plans. Interesting, more machinations of the Kirin Tor, it would seem.
I am a fool.
This is a powerful artifact. It was used frequently by powerful wizards of the Kirin Tor to channel magical energies. That they are delivering so many to Ambermill indicates that they must be undergoing a project of some magnitude. I will see if I can pierce their shields and ascertain their intent. Of course! How could I have forgotten? Ambermill was one of the sites earmarked by the Kirin Tor, noted because it houses a dormant Lay Energy node. The wizards must be planning to reactivate the node and use its energies for some greater purpose. We cannot allow this to happen. It will take a great amount of power to activate the area's Lay Energies. We can stall them by taking the pendants away from the wizards. Relay this information to Alistair. He will decide a course of action. I hope I can acquire enough energy from such a limited sample. Perhaps I should have had you get more shackles. Nonetheless, you showed great skill in collecting these, adventurer.
It will indeed take me longer than I had thought to uncover the dark secrets behind the enchantments Arugul was using. But in the meantime, I need you to take care of a slight problem our Darkstalkers have discovered. It seems that Arugul let his magic spread to the Deep Elam mine in the hills to the southeast. The mine would prove to be quite a resource for Verimathras' advance. I want you to behead the tainted foreman of the mine, Grimson the Pale. With his death, the mine shall be ours.
Ill news you bring, adventurer. If Dalar is correct, and I've no reason to believe he isn't, we must move quickly. I must confer with him on our plan of attack. But in the meanwhile, we will have to delay their progress.
Dalar is attempting to locate the source of the wizard's spellcasting. For now, we'll have to slow their progress in any way we can. The conjurers, mages, and protectors are no doubt carrying the pendants. Remove and retrieve them. Take the main road south and the eastern fork into Ambermill.
You say that this ring was worn by a woman recently killed? The only nearby source of such a body would be the mass graves in Tirisfal. The Rotthide Gnolls must be taking those corpses to Fenris Isle.
Before we launch an assault on Fenris Isle, we must determine who is behind the Rotthide Gnolls. Our apothecaries believe their origin lies within the strange fluid that flows through their bodies. Go to Fenris Isle, east of the decrepit ferry, and collect Rotthide Ichor from the gnolls you find there. Bring it to Apothecary Renferl, stationed outside the sepulchre. If you want to find the husband or beloved who gave Delia her ring, then speak with Magistrate Severin in Brill. He should have records of recent deaths and, with luck, can discover who Delia is. But I wouldn't hope. Whoever gave her the ring is probably dead, or if he's undead, he probably no longer cares about Delia.
Sorry, I was just curious about how easy it would be to do a logout skip in Undercity to skip the elevator on the way back up. But then there's the sewers, so we don't really care. I don't know, it's an idea. And I don't know where I'd end up. I'd probably have to do like a throwaway alt to make sure I don't end up someplace that is utterly unwelcome.
S-
speak.
How good of Apothecary Renferl to send you to me, adventurer? These samples will indeed prove useful to the cause. I will begin studying their toxic and contaminable properties at once.
You can be of further service to the Royal Apothecary Society, adventurer. When Arugal cast his wretched magic on the forest, he cursed one of our most promising members, Apothecary Berard. Now a mindless servant of Arugal, Berard is useless to us, but his findings might prove to be of worth. He was studying an ancient plague that killed off all the aquatic life in Lake Lordemir ages ago. Retrieve Berard's journal from his study in the Pyrewood Village Inn and take it to Apothecary Renferl.
Ah, yes, the heart samples of which Renferl spoke. I am eager to experiment with these. It is always of interest to the Royal Apothecary Society when new forms of toxins are discovered. A colleague in Kalimdor, Apothecary Helbrim, is researching the effects of Lordaeron toxins on the beasts of Kalimdor. He would be very interested in a sample of the wolf hearts Renferl sent me. Helbrim is stationed in the Barrens, in a village known as the Crossroads. To reach him, you must travel via Zeppelin to the Orc capital of Orgrimmar, then travel south by foot to Durotar. Head west into the Barrens and you will soon reach the Crossroads.
2 hours? Okay, well. Fuck that. BRB.
Thank you.
Salmon is ready. Baked herb salmon with veggies. It gave Frisbee a little bit earlier. He's normally not one for fish. But, yeah. Okay. Back into the game. Might disable the camera while I eat. See you in a bit. I might also mute my mic because, well, noises. Noises turn off people.
I came to the crossroads from the south seeking help, adventurer. But I find only cowards who turn their backs on me. Even the mighty Thork insults me so. He is a good leader, but his dismissal of my plea causes me greater anger. He claims my rage makes me hasty, that it clouds my judgment, but I will not rest until I have vengeance.
Perhaps you know the pain of uncertainty? Perhaps not, adventurer. But know this, I stand here every day from the sun's rising till its decline, scouring the horizon for more of those monsters. I've killed every pigman I've come across since, but my thirst for their blood is far from quenched. Perhaps instead of heading north to the crossroads, I should have headed to Toronto. You, adventurer, you could help me. Kill them. Kill as many as you can. Bring me their tusks and we will celebrate their deaths together.
We battled in a small Tauren camp when we were separated. She held three of the bristlebacks off by herself, but the odds began to overwhelm us. I led some away only to see her overwhelmed by newcomers. In my rage, I turned to face my enemies, but they brought me down easily with their vast numbers. I awoke to a Tauren druid tending my wounds. He had come across me on the gold road as I fell. Please, adventurer, find some sign of my wife.
The blasted harpies have been ravaging our caravan supplies for too long. It's time we slit a few of their throats and diminish their numbers. I've been snooping around their nests and figured out who leads who. The most devastating attack will destroy a good section of their lower chain of command, and then we can work our way to the top. I'll start you off slow. Take out Witchwing harpies and Witchwing rogue feathers in the northwest, and bring me 8 Witchwing talons. That should be a good start.
Ah, very good. If initial reports are true, then the toxicity of these hearts could lead to further advances in our knowledge of poisons. This is a welcome delivery, adventurer. Your reward is well earned.
I have need to send a crate of potions, reagents, and other items to my associates in the old world. Little time I have to actually see them to the dock at Ratchet, and the last caravan has already left. If you could, please take this to Wharfmaster Dizzywig. He will ensure that it is placed on the next boat to Blackwater Cove.
The oases of the Barrens hide a mystery. Life energy flows from their waters, invigorating the plants and beasts that drink it. Invigorating and altering, there is a mushroom that grows near these oases. Its spores hold properties that we, the apothecaries of Lordaeron, find useful. Bring me these spores and you will earn our gratitude.
That's what I get for being cocky. At least it wasn't a go-again moment.
Thank you.
take a food break while that calms down.
Oh.